फ्रेंड्स, आई डॉक्टर विनीता एंड वेलकम बैक टू फिजियोथेरेपी जुनून चैनल। एंड टुडेज आर टॉपिक इज ऑन गेम कीपर्स थंब। इंजरी टू द अल्नर कोलैटरल लिगामेंट ऑफ द थंब और मेटाकार्पोफेलेंजियल जॉइंट। सो बेसिकली इंजरी टू द मेटाकार्पोफेलेंजियल जॉइंट और अल्नर कोलैटरल लिगामेंट ऑफ द थंब, ए टीयर और एवल्जन ऑफ द लिगामेंट। There is some breakage between the ligament or there is avulsion fracture. Avulsion fracture in which ligament just pull your bone with the in the fracture. So it called the avulsion fracture. May occur at the site of insertion into the phalanx of the thumb. So here it can be happen. Scare thumb, acute condition. Gamekeeper's thumb, chronic condition as a result of repetitive episode. So first there is condition of scarce thumb where there is acute condition, or it leads to the chronic condition which we call gamekeeper's thumb. Or why it happened? Because of repetitive episode of injury. So the classic gamekeeper thumb was first described in Scottish gamekeepers, was coined by the Skulls and Brown in 1973, with skin being the most common cause of acute rupture, fall after a fall causing the ski pole to stress the UCL ulnar collateral ligament of the thumb. So the stability of the thumb on the ulnar side is maintained by four structures. And in this video, we will learn the anatomy part, we will learn the treatment part, we will learn the mechanism of injury, how it happened. So stay tuned and get some knowledge from this video. Gamekeeper's thumb, who kills small animals by forcefully extending the neck. Skiers who fall onto the extended thumb, hyperabduction. So gamekeeper's thumb like is different, like when forcefully extending the neck, okay, there is more pressure. Or in scare thumb, when we fall onto the extended thumb in hyperabduction position. So it mostly in athletes. What is anatomy behind this? The capsule is thickened medially and laterally to form the ulnar and radial collateral ligaments. So here you can see ulnar and radial collateral ligaments, which are static stabilizers of the metacarpophalangeal joints. So these are static stabilizers of the metacarpophalangeal joint. When we are not moving our thumb, that time our ulnar collateral ligament and radial collateral ligaments are working. Ligament proper and accessory ulnar collateral ligament. The capsule is thin over its dorsolateral aspect. So here the capsule is thin over its dorsolateral aspect between EPB, extensor pollicis brevis and abductor pollicis. Dorsomedially aspect between the EPB and the adductor pollicis. So these are some anatomical structures related to the gamekeeper's thumb. So the adductor aponeurosis, the adductor pollicis muscle, the proper and accessory ulnar collateral ligament and the volar plate. These are some structures which are maintained in ulnar side, and the ulnar collateral ligament provide resistance to radially applied forces. So when there is force in this direction, radially applied force, ulnar collateral ligament help to the thumb to provide resistance. Okay, pinching or holding large objects. For example, a torn ulnar collateral ligament weakness, the key pinch grip strength and allow volar subluxation of the proximal phalanx. With prolonged instability, the MCP joint frequently degenerated. So, like there, if there is instability or we are doing repetitive movement over and over again, that time it will cause to the frequently degenerate the MCP, metacarpophalangeal joint. So the amount of valgus laxity of normal thumb varies widely. In full MCP joint extension, valgus laxity average is 6 degree and 15 degree. 6 degree and 15 degree. 15 degree. And moreover, MCP joint flexion increased to an average of 12 degree. The adductor aponeurosis occasionally entrapped the ulnar collateral ligament, and what it caused, preventing the anatomical reduction or healing, and it is due to there is stenar lesion. Due to that, there is stenar lesion, and the typical mechanism of injury is an extreme valgus stress to the thumb. So in next slides we see that what is the stenar lesion. So before that, rupture of ulnar collateral ligament caused by forcible abduction. When we fall on to an outstretched hand, gamekeeper's fracture and avulsion fracture. Okay, so it's depend upon the force. When there is lateral force, that time there may be rupture of the ulnar collateral ligament, or there may be injury to the adductor aponeurosis. So this may happen partial rupture or complete rupture. There is two types. In this, there is partial rupture. It means that ligament is not completely torn. Thumb is unstable in flexion. Complete rupture, thumb is unstable in all the position because it is the complete rupture. So there is two types, partial and complete. Next is the stenar lesion, which we discussed earlier. The adductor aponeurosis, when torn and pulled distally, occasionally interrupt the ulnar collateral ligament. So here you see the stenar lesion, and preventing the anatomical reduction or healing. Okay, so this is called the stenar lesion because here is aponeurosis and it prevent healing of the ligament. Chronic instability present in about 80% of the complete ruptures. So interposition of the adductor pollicis aponeurosis between the end of the torn ligaments, like here. Clinical features: swelling, tenderness over the ulnar side of the thumb, metacarpophalangeal MCP joints, bruise like discoloration around the joint, interference in pinching activity or grasping, or laxity of the joint increase, lump or stenar lesions. So these may be happen due to this. So there is some test, like what you can do. So there is some test, abduction stress testing, joint in full extension and 30 degree of flexion should be compared with the uninjured thumb. So if there is injury to the right hand thumb, then you can compare it with the left hand thumb. And what you can do, abduction stress testing, you just abduct the thumb and give some stress over there on the joint in full extension and 30 degree of flexion. Then is the stress test in extension with abduction more than 40 degree and indicate a complete injury, because there is no abduction of 40 degree, so there is more laxity due to the injury. compared to other side difference of more than 15 degree. Next is the X-ray part. To exclude a fracture, avulsion fracture fragment from base of the proximal phalanx, subluxation, stress view examination and minimally displaced fracture. So we can examine it with the help of X-ray. What are complications due to this? Arthritic changes in the MCP joint because there is some injury to the proximal phalanx and there is subluxation, and it the prolonged instability may lead to the MCP joint frequently degeneration. So weak pinch grasp and stiffness of the MCP joint and IP joints, neuropraxia of the radial sensory nerve. So these may be happen in complication part. Rehabilitation protocol. After repair or reconstruction of the ulnar collateral ligament of the thumb, metacarpophalangeal joint, okay, at 3 weeks, what you can do, remove bulky dressing, okay, and then remove MCP joint pin, K-wire, if you use for joint stabilization. If there is K-wire, just remove it. Fit with wrist and thumb static splint for continual wear. 6 weeks, what you can do, begin active and gentle passive range of motion exercise. So at 6 weeks, what you can do, active and passive range of motion exercise for the thumb for 10 minutes each hour. So if you want to know about these exercises, there is a separate video, like for all the fingers, for all the joints, and you can watch that video. Avoid any lateral stress to the MCP joint of the thumb. Begin dynamic splinting if necessary to increase passive range of the thumb. At 8 weeks, discontinue splinting, wrist and thumb static splint or short opponent splint may be used during sports related activities or heavy lifting, and begin progressive strengthening exercises. And at 12 weeks, allow the patient to return to unrestricted activities. And if there is stable thumb on valgus dressing and there is no stenar lesion, so what you can do, the ligament is only partially torn and healing will occur with non-operative treatment. So here we can't go for operative treatment if there is stable thumb on valgus dressing and if there is no any stenar lesion and it's only a scarce thumb. It means that is acute injury. The thumb is immobilized for 4 weeks. So what we can do? Thumb is immobilized. First is immobilized for 4 weeks. Then in a short arm spica cast or thermoplast splint, molded usually with the thumb IP joint free, and active and passive thumb motion is begin at 3 to 4 weeks, but valgus is avoided. So here valgus is avoided. If range of motion is painful at 3 to 4 weeks, re-evaluation by a physician is indicated. The thermoplastic splint is removed several times a day for active range of motion. Grip strengthening exercise are begin at 6 weeks. So for grip strengthening exercise, you can use ball, Swiss ball, like smiley ball. After injury, a brace is worn for protection in contact situation for 2 months. Next is the unstable thumb or valgus dressing. Like if there is 30 degree of laxity, 30 degree of abduction, require direct operative repair with suture anchor, because 80% of the patient with a complete rupture are found to have a stenar lesion. thus obtaining a poor healing result if treated non-operatively, and it may cause MCP joint degeneration. So you have to tell the patient that go for surgery or go for operative treatment. It is critical to make the correct diagnosis of stable versus unstable gamekeeper's thumb. So there is requirement of some research that how we can easily define the unstable and stable skier's thumb, or between the gamekeeper's thumb, like in chronic conditions. So, and you can use x-ray for that, you can use small test for that. But if there is some condition in which you are not feeling stable, that time you go for operative treatment and just seek a help of orthopedician. So these things, all these are about the gamekeeper's thumb or seeker's thumb. I think this class is very helpful for you people. If this is helpful for you, please share it with your friends or share it with your junior or seniors, so that they can also watch and learn something in physiotherapy. And our main motive is that we can bring together like all the physiotherapists, and we will join a community, and we will enhance our knowledge. So my main motivation is that I want to motivate every single physiotherapist, and I want to just extend their knowledge. Like if I know something, I want to share with you all. So if you want to join me, you can join me on Telegram, Facebook, Instagram and YouTube. Thank you so much for giving me appreciation and giving me a chance to give something knowledgeable to you. Thank you so much.